Look around. There are so many things that separate us. Ethnicity, age, orientation, and background. But there are important things that we have in common that have brought us to this place, this room, this experience. We've all lost someone or something. We've all lived in these unprecedented days. We are all in need of refreshing. Refresh. To give new strength or energy to reinvigorate. We are all here to find that strength and energy. The Apostle Paul said it like this in Romans 15:32, "And that by God's will I may come to you with joy and be refreshed together with you." Now, here is a time for us to connect to one another, to the Spirit of God, to the Father Himself through Jesus Christ. It's time for us all to be reinvigorated, revived, and refreshed through worship. I get to say, welcome to Refreshed Worship Night.
Hey, we're just going to worship tonight, everybody. We're just going to seek God tonight. Y'all ready for that? Let's pray. You can stand, you can walk the room, do what you need to do. But Holy Spirit, we just welcome you in this place. Father God, have your way this evening. Surround us with your presence, God. We just pray right now. Surround us with your presence, God. Give us the revelation that everything we need is here in your presence. Everything we need is here in your presence, not in this building, but in your presence, God. So even if you're watching at home, he's there. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. Just anoint every set of hands on this stage, Lord God. Anoint every voice, Jesus, that your voice would be heard in this place. That your voice would be loud in this place tonight.
Fill the room,
fill the room.
some praise. Come on.
Testimony that God is a good God. Does anybody agree? Well, can you say it with me? God is a good God. We just want to sing a song about that today and have a good time. If you're not already on your feet, this is a good place to stand to your feet. And we just want to declare that in here. Hallelujah. Put your hands together like this.
You are the healer of the broken hearted. You are the mending when we're torn apart. You are the light that broke up the darkness. We see clearly who you are, good God. You are good God, yeah.
Come on, help me.
You're not afraid of all the fears that shape. You fought the battle.
Good God,
said Father,
Father,
healer,
healer,
creator,
Good God,
good God,
good God,
good God,
good God,
save your
Come on, I don't know about you, but we came to worship tonight. Yes. We came to worship tonight. If y'all ain't out of breath, you ain't do it right. I'm just saying. We just getting started. Just gonna declare it tonight. For you swore high, you were seated on high, you spoke time, we were already on your mind. Can't explain your love without performance. You called us your own, couldn't afford it. With your blood, you bought our freedom. Can't explain your love. Sing it out, church. Worthy of all that we could bring. Hey. You are great, Jehovah. All power is yours. Hey!
No sin.
you, God. We worship you, Jesus. God, thank you for your presence, Jesus. Something together, and we're going to continue our time of worship. And when we come back, it's no more patty cake worship. We're going to go in. All right, let's watch this.
What's going on, everybody? Pastor Sean here. Wanted to just say how excited I am about Matt and this whole worship experience here and this refresh moment. Man, God is doing some amazing things in his life and doing some amazing things throughout our nation right now and in this city. And I believe this is a strategic moment where we can line up worship moments, where we can seek God's face, and we're gonna see God really start to do something amazing in our lives, but also in our communities and in our nation. If we would just begin to get on our face and worship God, watch what he does. And I think this is a perfect time to give to something like this. I'm asking all of you out there, if you want to be a part of this and see this thing move forward, I'm asking you to be a part financially. Give today and be a part of what God is doing with these worship experiences, with these refresh moments. I believe that God is going to spark revival, going to spark a movement, going to spark a heart of worship, and God is getting ready to do something. So I'm asking you, ask God what you can do this year, right now, to give, to move this movement forward. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you so much for faithful givers. I thank you that, Lord God, you're going to use these gifts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Within this world, I can't believe all that you've done in me. It is your greatness we pursue, just to be like you. It's all we want to be. It is all I want to be. Well, would without the cross. Lost within this world, I can believe all that you've done in me. It is your greatness we pursue, just to be like you. It's all we want to be. It is all I want to be. Come on, say, where would we be? Say, within this world. Just to be like you, your greatness we pursue. Just to be like you, it is all we want to be. It is all we want to be. Oh.
Can we sing that out?
Make me like you. Make me like you.
Take all.
Burn me name it is, what a beautiful name it is. Name above all.
just tremble, Jesus, Jesus. You silence fear.
Silence fear.
Oh, Jesus, Jesus. You make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus.
Come on, sing it again.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You make.
This is how.
that knows what it feels like to, for it to look like you're losing. I don't know about you, but I know what it looks like. Look, I know what the doctor says. I know what my bank account looks like. I know what I'm feeling, right? I know what my friends say. I know the lack of friends that are saying anything, but I know what it looks like. But now you need to speak to your situation, say, but I'm surrounded by you. I know what it looks like. It looks like loss. It looks like failure. It looks like sickness. It looks like lack, but I'm surrounded. To go ahead and convince yourself that you're surrounded tonight. You took a big step and came out. You took a big step and locked in, okay? So I know what it looks like, but we worship to our situation and say, but I'm surrounded by you. And when I'm surrounded by him, I'm all right. Y'all ready to speak to it? All right, here we go. I know what it looks like. Oh, but I'm surrounded by you. Say,
by you.
I know what it looks like.
I know what it looks like.
But I'm surrounded. Say,
but I'm surrounded
by you.
Here.
surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Come on, sing it out. It may look like I'm surrounded. This is how. You need to sing this at your house today. But I'm surrounded by you. I know what this marriage looks like. I know what my children look like. Come on, somebody. I know what my struggles look like.
Feel led to leave yet, but I'm surrounded by you. But I'm surrounded by you. Come on, sing it out. But I'm speaking right now. Give us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. Clean hands. Give us pure hearts to hear your voice. To hear your voice above the noise. Hear your voice. To hear your voice above the noise. Give us clean hands and a pure heart to hear your voice above the noise. Be where you are.
afraid not to sing another written lyric, afraid just to be with you. Filling us up. I've been running on empty, hearing your presence. We've been running on empty, now we're hearing your presence.
Fill me up.
Feel the presence of God in your life right now. I just feel the presence of God. We're going to try to leave out here. But I just want to say I'm so appreciative that you guys came out tonight. I want to share a little bit. Some of you guys might have saw I shared some stuff on Facebook and things like that. But this was one of those things where I just really felt it was a God thing. And I know that there's a very real COVID thing and there's a very real safety precautions that need to be taken, and so I know a lot of people were hesitant to come in person, but we're watching online, and I appreciate you guys being a part. This was something that I was reminded. Gabrielle told me, she said, you realize you wanted to do this when you lived in Pittsburgh? And I was like, no, I didn't realize that. But it was something that was that long ago. I lived in Pittsburgh about 3 years ago, and it was something that I was carrying then. And I remember writing in a book that I had during some type of worship event that I went to, and I wrote down the word refresh. And I just started blotting down like random ideas that were coming to me, and it was like creating a space where people could come and be refreshed. Creating a worship environment where people could come and just be refreshed. Where they could just feel the presence of God. Where there was no pressure to perform. There was no pressure to serve. There was no pressure to give. It was just, you know, just come and experience God, right? And in the process, you know, maybe trip acquaint, train, equip, those words. And, you know, maybe even create some community where people that, you know, could really use other people like that, right? So, long story short, I met an awesome woman of God named Angelique Wren. And we started doing a couple events together, and she would bring me in, I'd do some worship. She called me on a Tuesday, and she said, hey, I think we should do a worship night. I just want to let you loose, do your thing. And I was like, that sounds cool. So I was telling her, I said, you know, to be honest with you, I've been carrying this thing. I've been wanting to do that for the past couple months. But I was just thinking of every excuse not to. I was like, I ain't got the right people. I don't have the right space. We don't have the right technology. I don't have the time. Anything you could think of, the funds, whatever it was. So I just didn't do it. And when she called me, she was like, yeah, let's just do it. So I was like, okay, cool, let's do it. So I was very much, it was her vision that I was just jumping on board with, but it was something that God had given me for a long time. And I honestly do believe that God will give you stuff, and if you don't use it, he'll just put it in someone else's hands and be like, all right. Now you have to be in the passenger seat. You could have been the driver. So we talked on a Tuesday. We were excited. And on a Sunday, I got a call that said she passed away. She wasn't sick. She wasn't under the weather. She wasn't dealing with some secret stuff. She literally was on a phone call and passed out, went to the hospital. She was gone. And I'll be honest, I was like, huh? And I tried to sing at her funeral. I did a horrible job. Don't ask me to sing at funerals if I know you, all right? not wise. But she was really special. And I didn't know her a very long time, but the time that I did know her, she constantly pushed me to do the things that she knew I had in me. And she's just one of the many people that have done that. And so when I was thinking about, I still had this date in my calendar that said Angelique worship time for December 5th. And I just thought, man, what better way to honor, you know, who she was and what she was doing in me and that God was using her than to keep that date. And I shared that with everybody here, and I was like, hey, I don't know. I just have a thing in my heart to launch out and do this. Will you be a part? And everybody was like, yeah. Shay was like, maybe, but she did it, you know, so that's cool. That's good. She's here. No. So obviously we kept the date, and not only to honor her, but really just to honor God. And I was just like, you know what, God, I'm going to really try my best to not do this ever again. To just like, when you give me something and you tell me to do it, I'm just going to do it. And I know that's easier said than done. Because there's 1,000 things today that didn't go the way I wanted. And a part of me is like, that's why you shouldn't have did it. But I'm just being obedient, man. I'm just being, just, you know, I think this is what God gave me to do. So I really hope you were blessed. I really hope that you met with God tonight. I hope that you at home are watching, you met with God. I hope that as this stays online, people find it in the next weeks or months or years and say, man, that was awesome. But what I want to do is I want to leave out this place with some praise, all right? I want to be excited about what God's doing, okay? So we're not going to leave sad. Y'all sad? All right, cool. If you could get on your feet, we're going to worship God. Y'all ready? Huh? My name? Y'all know my name. My name's Matt Carmona. What's up? She said, tell them your name. I said, everybody know me here. Okay. For the interwebs, my God. All right, let's go. We gonna leave out of here with some high praise tonight. Let's go. Hey.
He who abides in me will forever be fruitful indeed. Hey. And I am the way, the truth, in the light. No one gets to the Father except that he comes through me.
Come on, let me hear you say,
let my mercy
and truth
say forsake you.
Y'all sing it out.
Is refreshing each and every time you watch it. I pray it's refreshing every time you think of it. I pray it's refreshing every time it comes on your mind. I pray that you would just leave this place better than you walked in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank y'all so much. We're going to close. For all the people online, go ahead and watch this. For everybody in the house, be safe. Getting home. Love you. Okay, let's give it up for everybody up here real quick. Come on now. Peoples.
We are excited about Revive Worship Nights. This is just the first of many, so be on the lookout on what's coming down the pike. If you want to get involved and be a part of what God's doing with this, there are multiple ways to give. You can do that here. Don't forget that you want to stay up to date with what's going on. Like, subscribe, be a part of the community that we're building. Refresh Worship Night is just the first. There's going to be Refresh Talks. There's going to be Refresh Leadership training. So there's all kinds of stuff that's going to be happening, all to better the kingdom, all to be a place of refreshing for people. So stay tuned to what's next. Big shout out to the team. Y'all give a big shout out to them because they just did an amazing job. So thank you to everybody that was involved. I love you from the bottom of my heart. God bless you. I'll see you later.